Hello everyone, welcome to PC Talk. I'm your host, Dante Bond. Today, we got two special guests who also go to Pearl Cohn Entertainment Magnet High School. We got Ms. Kenedra Wilson and Ms. Jojetta. How you doing?
Good, and you?
All right, so our topic today, you're talking about the school system. My first question is, how do you feel about the school system?
I feel it could be changed in many ways.
I feel the same too.
Okay. I feel that maybe it can be a better place and got some flaws, but it's coming up through the rise. So my next question is, if you can change one thing about the school system, what would it be?
Maybe the times, I guess.
We do need to change the times too. Kind of miss 205 a little bit. 245, it's a little bit long. I don't like that. What do you think, Ms. JoJo?
I go with school policies.
You go with school policies? It's always great to go with school policies. I believe in that. My next question is, what can you do to make the school system better?
I guess by talking to the teachers and principals and students, agreeing up on one thing instead of the teachers and principals agreeing on one thing and the students on a different side of it.
Okay. And I like to add on to what you said too as well. I like to add on to say that we can do more hands-on experiments. You know, if we having trouble, we can talk to the teachers, ask, hey, I don't know what I'm supposed to do, and then they can help us out in there. Yeah. And then we'll be able to graduate. What do you think, Ms. Jojetta?
Same thing, basically, working together and coming up with ideas.
That's good, that's really good. My next one is with the test scores, which they came up from last year to this year, so there's been an advancement in that. What do you think the advancements changed in order to make those test scores come up from where it was back from last year?
I'm not really sure what you think about it.
I feel that teachers changed, like it was a teacher change. Mostly schools are getting grants. More schools are teaching more about the tests. And I think that they can make more of a difference to that. Okay, I got the next question. What makes you enjoy the classroom now? Is it more hands-on or is it more textbook?
It's more hands-on, less textbook.
Okay. I'm saying, how you feel about the teachers?
Some of them you can enjoy, you can relate to a lot of them. And like you can go to that teacher outside of that class and be able to have a conversation, not just about school, it could be about personal things.
All right, well, we ran out of topics today, so we'd like to wrap up. Thank you for coming with us. All right, this has been Dante Bond. Thanks for PC Talk, and we'll see you next time.
What's up, everyone? My name is Ronald Connor, and this is PC Talk. We're here with Danaya and Hyde. How are you guys doing today?
All right.
Good.
All right, today we're gonna be answering a question vacation planners and hotels have been trying to answer for their whole lives. What is the dream vacation?
Paris.
My dream vacation has always been to go out of the country and go on a major shopping spree.
Do you have any locations set in mind for that?
Paris.
I think I would pick like the Eiffel Tower.
What is so significant in Paris and the Eiffel Tower?
I just always wanted to take a picture there and propose to a woman there.
Okay.
Is there any other things you guys would do on this vacation?
I would be like sightseeing and exploring, you know, I forgot the word.
All right, if somebody told you that you could not go on your dream vacation, where else would you go? Is there any other place besides Paris you guys have in mind?
To go for a shopping spree, I go to Atlanta and go to Lenox Mall or go to Minnesota because they got the biggest mall in the world.
And what makes a vacation great?
Shopping.
Just shopping
and like seeing different places like that we don't have in Nashville.
We have some pretty cool stuff in Nashville.
No, we don't.
If you were to go, say you were from somewhere else, if you're going on vacation to Nashville, what would you go? Like, what would you do in Nashville? What is there to do here?
First thing I do is go to a Titans game, and then I probably go to the Country Music Hall of Fame and see what's going on down there. Or go to a Prayers game, something like that.
Yeah, that's really about it down here.
What was your funnest vacation as a child that you went to your family?
Funnest vacation as a child is me going to Gatlinburg when I went with my family. I just explored a lot and went on the strip and seen a lot, did a lot, and went to a, did a lot of things.
Gatlinburg, if not mistaken, that isn't too far from Dollywood, is it?
No, it's not.
What kind of stuff does they have there?
I ain't never been to Dollywood.
You've never been?
No.
Have you?
Mm-mm.
It was pretty fun there. I liked it a lot. Is there anything else?
No, I just go out a lot, you know. I just love vacations.
All right, well, unfortunately, guys, we're about to run out of time and get to the 30-second mark here. So this is all. We'll see you guys next time. This has been PC Talk. My name is Ronald Connor.
Welcome to PC Talk. I'm your host, Diamond Bell, and these are my guests, Jojetta and Bobby. Our topic today is going to be celebrities. So my first question is, do you use social media? If so, like, which sites do you use?
Well, I use sites like Instagram, Twitter, stuff like that.
What about you?
I use the same thing, Snapchat, Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, all of them.
Oh, so
I MySpace.
You still use MySpace?
Yeah, I do. I'll be chatting with Tom.
Okay, who do you follow on these social websites?
I follow like Chris Brown, That Is Love, my fiance Kim Kardashian, and
What about you?
I follow a lot of people.
I personally don't really. I'm not too fond of Kim Kardashian. So what have y'all seen, like, scandals that the celebrities have been in? Like, how do you feel about those?
Terrible. There's just too much going on.
How do you feel?
I feel like some of them should have probably thought about the stuff they did before they did it.
I think that also. Like, you should think about decisions that you make before you make them.
Yeah, you should.
And, like, how do y'all feel about the Blac Chyna situation with her getting a tattoo of Future's name on her?
I think that was so unnecessary. Like,
Yeah. So I feel like a lot of people took it out of proportion. Like, it could have just been the word Future.
Yeah. And then, you know, plus, you know, like, she could have also, like, had, like, some weird stuff set up and be in love with Sierra's baby. You know, that might be the baby's name, Future. Just get it tatted, you know.
Right.
Yeah.
I'm just like, probably a lot of people just took it out of proportion, I believe. So, like, do y'all use social media on a daily basis? Is it, like, an everything thing for y'all?
Yes, mm-hmm. Every day.
Like, you wake up and...
Mm-hmm.
That's bad. What about you?
I use it from time to time. Not 24/7, but every once in a while I get on it.
So you don't just wake up like she do? You
nah, she, nah. She wake up, Snapchat.
All of that. I'm a Snapchat person. I really love Snapchat.
Yeah, I can tell.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You can tell.
Yeah, I can.
I don't use MySpace. I don't know anybody who still uses it. It's kind of...
You know me.
It's old.
Yeah, it's weird that you
old
still
school.
Use it.
Yeah.
It's weird that you don't.
So what's on it that you like so good?
Stuff. Don't worry about it. Go check it out.
This is coming to the end of the show. I'm glad that I can have y'all on my show. And join us next week on PC Talk, where our topics will be different. Thank you, and have a nice night.
Have a wonderful evening.
Hi, my name is Deanna Kiritan for PCTV, and today I have two guests, Hyde and Marvin. I'm going to ask them a couple questions. What devices do you guys use today?
I use my phone and iPad, tablet, computer, stuff like that.
Nowadays, I primarily use my game systems, such as PlayStation 2, 3, 4, you name it, and also my Android phone, S4, and computers.
That's a lot of things that you use. What are the pros and cons of using technology?
The pros are, like, you got access to social media and stuff like that. And the cons is, like, it can crash at any moment, and because there's so much technology in the world, and ain't no telling when it's gonna crash, and it can just shut off whenever it want to, and you can't do nothing about it.
Some pros, I guess, are that it's a helpful resource for humanity. And some cons is that some people can spam you online about bad stuff. You know, they could cyberbully you at any time or any day, and they can catfish you like they done a couple people.
What kind of game systems you use and why?
I use Xbox 360, Xbox One, PlayStation 3, PlayStation 4, and I like them all. I think PlayStation 4 is the best one because you get Netflix and you don't have to really pay for it. Well, you do. You gotta pay for it. You gotta pay for it. And then, yeah, it is good. I like it. I really do.
I don't know about anyone else, but I'm a PlayStation fan. I'm not for Xbox really, but it's just a good game system that I've been with since I was little.
Why don't you like Xbox?
Because it's fruity. It's they're too greedy for money and other stuff.
What do you mean by fruity?
Like, they do too much. Like, they demand money even for a pack of batteries, for the back of the controller. Like, you come up to them like, really? It's fruity.
Okay, that's interesting. That's all the time that we have. Thanks for all the viewers for watching and tune in next time. I'm Deanna Kiriton for PCTV.
Hi, welcome to the Nighttime Hour. I'm your host, Javonda Grissom, and I have two guests, Bobby and DB. We're here to talk about Pearl Cohn violence. My first question is, how would you feel about violence at Pearl Cohn?
Well, I say that violence is a bad thing, and Pearl Cohn violence, when it involves with the school and the community, it sends a wrong tone to the rest of the city, and it puts a bad image on us, especially the students.
Yeah, I feel the same. It puts a bad image, cause like when you talk about Pearl Cohn to like people that don't go or associated with Pearl, that's the first thing they think is, oh, if you go to Pearl, you finna get shot. Yeah, that's the first thing they say.
Okay, what do you feel about is a major cause of the violence in Team Current in Pearl?
I mostly say it's gang violence with all the gangs running around and teenagers that are our age getting killed, and their parents who are deeply saddened and hurt by their child getting shot, because they never expected that. And it really like hardens and burdens everyone else in that community, so everyone tries to make it better.
Yeah, that's same here. Like, I think one of the problems is like violence. One of the causes of violence is, you know, like gangs and then like drugs too, you know, like selling weed, you know, get caught up.
Drugs.
Yeah, then that's people's fastest way to retaliate is to shoot people. So.
Do you think violence can be prevented in Pearl Cohn?
I believe it can. I believe it can be prevented. It can't be stopped, but it can be prevented by having community events and services and people coming out and supporting and trying to rebuild the community into a positive way to where anybody can just come and not feel scared, but they feel safe. And
I feel the same way. Like, I don't really know how to explain it, but yeah, what you said, yeah.
Okay, this is all the time we have today. So I'd like to thank Bobby and DB for showing up.
Thank you for letting us come on here.
This is the Nighttime Hour, and I'll see you later.
Welcome to PC Talk. My name is Kanija Wilson, and today I have with me Diamond Bell and Marvin Prather. Today we will be talking about school lifestyle. So my first question is, how's life inside and outside of school?
Life inside of school, I don't have it like other people. I'm more of an introvert. And life outside of school, Usually around my family, I can express myself the way I want myself to, instead of being all professional.
That's interesting. And what about you?
I'm the same in school and high school, I feel like. But not in school, like, really it's the same. Yeah, it's the same.
Okay. My next question is, which lifestyle would you choose, inside or outside of school?
Me personally, I would choose life outside of school because I don't have to worry about grades and all that other stuff and dressing a certain way.
I would choose outside of school because I hate school, so it's not for me.
Why do you hate school?
Because I don't like getting up early, and I don't like doing work, and I don't like the fact that I can't use my phone, and I don't like all the schools, the standard school type.
So what's your favorite thing to do when you're outside of school?
I like to hang with my family, and I like to listen to music and to chill. I work too. It's cool though.
Yeah, I like to chill. I like to stay laid back. Not much to do, really.
So my next question is, do you stay in touch with your friends when you're out of school, like on the weekend or for breaks or anything?
No.
I don't have friends, so you feel me?
Yeah, no.
Why not?
Just not many of my friends contact me. I don't have too many friends.
Okay. My next question is, when you have homework, do you do it on the weekends or for your weekend time do you spend with your friends?
I don't do homework.
I don't really do any of my homework.
Why? Isn't it great?
I finish it in class. I don't do it for homework.
I don't get homework. No. And it ain't great. I don't get it. We don't get it.
My next question is, do you have any siblings that go to your school?
Yeah, I got one.
Yes, I do. I have a little brother. He's a sophomore.
You got a little brother?
Yes.
He look like you?
Yes.
Okay, well, thank you for the time. Join us again next week, 6 o'clock. Thank you. Thank you, everybody, for watching. Have a great night.
Hello, my name is Kenedra, and you're watching the Music Channel. Today, my guest is Marvin, and I have always wanted to find out more about you. I'm super excited and here and excited that you're here. Who inspired you to be a music man?
An artist named Michael Jackson.
Who's your favorite artist to listen to?
Michael Jackson and Aaliyah.
What type of music do you like?
All kinds of music, just not too big on country.
What made you like Michael Jackson? What stand out to him?
Well, honestly, I don't know how to answer that question, but I was raised listening to his music by my parents since my mom and dad like his music, so I was listening to him all my life.
That's good. How has your life been a celebrity?
It sucks.
Why?
I mean, I don't have what I want. Even though I have all this fame and fortune, it's not what I want. It's not what I'm seeking.
Is it hard to be in spotlight all the time?
Pardon?
Is it hard to be in the spotlight all the time?
Yeah, you get nervous, you cry, you get butterflies.
Do you write your own music or you have somebody write it for you?
Oh, no, I can't write music. I have someone else do it.
Do you help them or they just write it out and then you just take
it? They do it by themselves. Not me.
Tell me about life, like, how you were raised and born.
Well, in my childhood, I was bullied. And that's why I don't really associate with too many people. So I'm getting everyone back.
How do people feel about you or your music?
They like my music, but they don't like me.
Why?
Because I'm a jerk.
Has there ever been a time where, like, you go on stage and you feel like dizzy or sick or like you don't want to do it after you're already there?
No.
That's interesting. So you're comfortable being on stage all the time?
No.
So what do you do in your free time?
Sleep. the most I can before I had to go on the next tour.
Well, thanks for watching the music channel. Today, my guest was Marvin. We'll see you next time.
Hello, my name is Danae, and welcome to my show, Movie Time. I am interviewing Dante. What kind of movies do you like?
Well, I like a little bit of action, a lot of comedy, and just really good movies in general.
What is your favorite movie?
I really don't have one. I have a lot of favorite one. My favorites when I was a child, but not as much.
Do you have any favorite characters out of certain movies?
I like Chicken Little, cause he, like, everybody didn't really believe in him at first, and then when it actually happened, everybody relied on him, and he saved the world pretty much.
Chicken Little, okay. Well, what do you like about Chicken Little?
He's funny and he's small. So okay. I kind of relate to him because I'm short. So.
Okay, yeah. That's understandable. What's your favorite movie genre? Like comedy, action?
I mostly like comedy because I like a good laugh in movies, and mostly it gives me a vision of what I want to do a little bit.
Is there any other genres that you like?
Action. Can I ask you another question? What movies do you like?
I like action and scary movies.
Yeah, me too. I do like those a little bit. So, I'm just wondering, as a host, how does it feel to be on here?
It's about normal. At first, you get used to it after a while.
And it's straight. Okay. What movie parts do you like, or do you have a favorite character?
Favorite movie? I don't even know. I ain't never just thought about that. I guess it would be Empire. Well, my favorite TV show right now is Empire.
Yeah, a lot of people do like Empire. Yeah, you saw that episode last night?
Yeah, pretty good. Hakeem was savage. Okay.
Savage. Terrible. So, who's your favorite actress or actor?
I say it's Hakeem. But that's we're about done. So, this is Movie Time. We'll see you next time.
Hello, my name is Bobby, and today you're watching the Music Channel. Today we have Deanna Curtin. I've always wanted to find out more about you. I'm super excited that you're here.
Excited to be here today.
Okay. All right. So you're a big person in music. So who inspired you to start? To take part in the music industry?
Nicki Minaj, I guess. I don't know.
Nicki Minaj, you like her?
Yeah, I love
her. Yeah, that's what she think. so like, you know, you do like rap music and stuff. You be rapping sometimes. But like, what kind of music do you listen to?
I listen to a lot. I listen to rap, R&B, some old school stuff.
You listen to Taylor Swift?
Yeah, I do.
Yeah,
I do.
Yeah. Yeah, that's my stuff. So, you're married to Justin Timberlake. What's it like being married to another celebrity? What's it like? Is it fun?
It's kind of hard because, you know, we don't get to see each other a lot because I work, he work, and so we try to fit in, like, try to find ways for us to, I don't know.
Yeah. I feel you. So like, you know, you haven't done any recent concerts. So is it hard being in the spotlight? Is it like a certain reason?
It really is, cause you know you get butterflies, you get nervous. But once you get out there, you know, you hear the fans calling your name and stuff. You know,
They would call me your name. They would like, Brianna.
Yeah.
Brianna. That's how something you don't say? Yeah, I know. So how long does it like does it take like a long time to record a song?
Yeah, because you got to know what how you want it, and it's got to if it's got to sound how you want it to be.
Okay, that's good. So when you first started, you know, not everybody starts out big. So like, how did people first find out about your musical talents?
I did a song with Justin Bieber. it went viral. So
it went viral. It was viral, but it wasn't Baby, though. That was the song. I ain't gonna type Baby. Baby, baby, baby. Nah.
Don't sing that again.
That was that song. You wasn't on it, though. But, yeah, but, you know, Justin Bieber is another big person. But, unfortunately, we're running out of time. And I hope everybody has a safe night. And this has been Bobby Jennings with The Music Show. Nah, good night.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to the social media show. I'm Georgetta, and this is Kanidra. And today we're going to be talking about Snapchat.
Yes, girl.
But, girl, have you heard that Snapchat is the next biggest thing going on?
Yes, don't nobody get on Instagram, Facebook, none of that. We all about Snapchat.
So, how do you feel about that?
Girl, I like Snapchat. Only thing I don't like about it is you can't save people's stories. You know how you want to be nosy sometimes?
Yeah.
Just save it.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
Can't do all that, but you can screenshot, though.
Exactly. So how often do you get on Snapchat?
Girl, every day. When I wake up, from the time I wake up to the time I go to sleep. Every day.
Same here. So, and I heard they have updated, and there's this little new thing where you can change the voice and make it go in fast or slow motion. You think that's really cool?
I ain't seen it. You gotta show it to me.
All right, let's check it out, girl. So I really enjoy this new update that they got on Snapchat. I cannot stay off Snapchat, this is everything.
Yes, girl. Turn up. Okay. I see it.
So how do you feel about everything?
I like it. I think we should keep it. I don't think Snapchat gonna go nowhere. You know how MySpace disappeared, Facebook finna disappear. Snapchat gonna always be around.
Yeah, I think everyone really enjoy using Snapchat.
Because they always update it. The updates be fine.
Right. So, you got anything else in mind that you want to say or ask me about Snapchat and all these other social media?
Let me see. When you get on Snapchat, you know how when you add your friends?
Mm-hmm.
Do it automatically add them from your contact list or you just add them yourself?
I add them from my contact list.
Is that easier for you?
Yeah, it's much more easier and better.
Yeah, because I get tired of people asking, what's your Snapchat? If I got your number, I'm just going to go and click.
Right.
Thank you, see.
You know, girl.
Yes. Oh, my gosh. Yes. That's okay. The best part.
Yeah, right.
Only time I hate can't get on Snapchat when we're in school. You know, that cell phone policy. I don't like that.
That really sucks.
Yes.
It's really not good. I love Snapchat. I stay on Snapchat every time.
Yeah, as soon as we get out of the classroom, be on Snapchat. Be walking down the hallway. Girl, what's up?
Wake up in the middle of the night, get on Snapchat.
Yes, let me check out these people's stories.
Okay, so what more do you have to tell about Snapchat or any other
Snapchat stuff? Is life. That's all.
That's good.
How you feel about Snapchat?
Well, I feel the same way. Snapchat is real fun, interesting, and it's just everything. It's my life right now. I can't live
without it. Yes. Snapchat go away, I'm gonna cry. For real.
Yeah, I probably would cry too. So anyways, we run out of time. That's all we have for you for today. And we hope that you enjoy the show. And thank you for watching.
Bye.
Bye, y'all.
Hi, I'm your host, and welcome to the Diamond Morning Show. Today, my guest is Hyde, and we're going to be talking about fashion. So, Hyde, what is your favorite brand name clothes to wear?
I like Nike a whole lot, if anybody know me. I don't wear nothing but Nike socks. All my pants is True Religion. All my shirts is True Religion, Nike. And, you know, Robin, you know, stuff like that.
But the other day when we was here, you was like, you don't really wear True Religion like that. That's just
because it done got old now. It's back to Robin. You know, we gotta switch it. My pants I got on now, they Levi's. You feel me? Like.
So that's what you like to wear?
Yeah, yeah.
They comfortable?
They ain't comfortable. They got that V cut. You know, Wrangler got that, you know, that U.
I guess.
Yeah. So it all worked out for the best.
Okay. I like, I don't know. I really like the No Face jackets. They comfortable.
Yeah. We both got them on right
now.
Yeah,
that's cool.
Yeah, that's cool. Like, they get hot, though.
Yeah.
Like, if it's hot in the room, you hot. You start sweating, like, whew.
No, like, this morning, I had to run back to my house. I was all the way up the street, and I had to go back and get something to drink.
I seen it on Snapchat.
And it was hot. Like, yeah. I was hot. Yeah. I get mad when I run. It was awful.
Yeah, I just, mine kind of big, you know, but it's cool. Like,
so you got a little paint on there right there, too?
Yeah, yeah, that ain't paint. But, what's up? What's your favorite brand? What you like doing?
well, like, pants, it really don't matter. Like, they cool. Like, it's just long as your clothes comfortable.
Yeah, look,
I'm not, you know, like, I'm a real cheap person. Like,
see, me, my mama told me I'm materialistic, so she said it's a little bit I can do. It's a little, only a few things I can wear, so. I gotta get out here and get it how you live. I want them robbers, I gotta go spend. See, the one thing is, though, them robbers, they cost like $500.
And I'm just not finna pay that for nothing.
I will, though, cause.
If it's one something, no, I'm
like
not.
Like my
doing
socks,
it.
My socks, all my socks is $12 a pack. It only come with 3 pairs. And then, like, only kind of shoes I wear is Air Force Ones.
Yeah. Nike. I like Nikes.
Yeah.
Like, I'm a real big Nike person.
Like, yeah. Timberland, Air Force One, something simple. Something you can wear every day.
Right.
Yeah.
Well, that was all for this show today. Had the great guest with me, Hyatt, and it was a great little
Ludo,
show.
Ludo, shout out to Diamond. Follow me on Instagram.
Okay, and
Snapchat,
thanks for the show, and we'll see y'all later.
100.
Thanks.
Hey, what's up, everyone? Welcome to What Are Those? And my name is Marvin Prather, and this is
Danaya.
And I have a couple questions for her. So, what kind of shoes do you like to wear?
I'm strictly like Jordans, Nike. I don't do too much boots and all that.
Mm-hmm. I see you trying to swag it out with some J's and stuff like that. Or like, what kind of colors do you wear? Like,
most of my shoes, they be like black with like a color that coordinates, like black, red, black, pink, stuff like that.
Yeah, got that evil look, demon. all right. How long you been wearing J's?
Since I was little. I ain't never just been a boots. I got straight brothers, really, so.
So did any kind of family encourage you to wear those, or are they just personal taste?
This is what my mama started buying, so this is what I started wearing.
I feel you. So, what do you like about J's? You play any sports? Like?
No, but everybody keeps saying I look like a hooper, so I'm gonna play basketball. Let me find a basketball boyfriend. Yes.
You air about a ball, I'm gonna smack you. No, I'm messing with you.
Anyway.
All right. So, are there any like other type of shoes you wear? Like?
Like, I wear boots if somebody make me wear them. Cause my mama, she be like, I look like a boy by the feet, then I'm a girly girl up top. So if she make me wear boots, I wear them occasionally, but it's just not. I'm mostly Jordans and Nike, that's it.
So you don't wear it just to fit in?
What you mean? You trying to copy a follower?
No. So, like, I'm just saying, do you wear them to fit in, or
I wear them because I like them. I mean, I don't care.
So, what kind of J's are those?
These are sixes, infrareds.
All right. So, do your J's match your clothes, or do you wear?
I match a little bit today. I don't care. I'm at school.
Yeah.
I don't care.
I don't know what that is.
What kind of shoes you wear, since you on me?
All right, then. Well, averagely I wear Nikes or some kind of pullovers, nothing much, something with not much lace activity. And long socks, just average. It matches my outfit. So we're running low on time. Nice to meet you.
Nice meeting you.
And we'll see y'all guys later at 6.
Follow me on Snapchat.
What are those? Later. Peace.
Hello, everybody. Welcome to the Bond Show, starting your host, Dante Bond. My guest today, I have Ms. Kenedra Wilson. How you doing?
Good, man.
All right. Today's topic, work. What do we hate about it? What do we like about it? What's the main thing that we're just doing it for? I want to start the topic with Ms. Kenedra talking.
Work. Let's see. I have 3 jobs. I don't do it just for the money. I do it so I can save and for the future, so I can have backup money. Irritating parts sometimes can be customers or co-workers or the day period. Be ready to go home. But other than that, be good, fun, work with people that make you laugh. Yeah. What about you?
I work at the Boys and Girls Club. It's okay. Sometimes the kids can be a little messy. Like one time it was lunchtime and then I had to clean up some stuff and I had to take out some trash. Got mad one day. Didn't really take it out on anybody. I just got mad, went on my break, and then got something to eat. But overall, work is good. I like working with kids a lot, and I feel that they're the future. And I like that. Sometimes I just want to strangle them, though. I just hate that. I hate them sometimes. But I can understand about your workplace, though, having to work around food a lot, and then customers can kind of be a little salty at times.
Yeah,
though, but
I know.
I can understand that, even though I never worked there before. And I'm trying not to work there. But, you know, the main objective is that we're working, we know how it is. Then once we do get age to where we can work anywhere we want, we don't have to worry about that. And we just look back on it.
You'll be used to the work ethic by then.
Yeah, but like, so what else do you like about it, or like what irritates you a lot sometimes? Like, give me a scenario.
Well, one thing I like about it is when I work with the Sound Stadium, since the baseball season is over with, we go to Western Kentucky and work football and basketball games. And the football games, it'd be fun to watch in the basketball games. It'd be interesting seeing how college is different from high school or middle school, stuff like that. So it's different. It's fun going out from Nashville, I guess you could say, to different places. It's fun.
Okay. But yeah, I can understand that work is kind of important sometimes, and it's always nice to get that little paycheck, you feel me?
Go spend a little bit, but you know you always gotta save.
Yeah. Well, that's about a wrap up this time for our show. Thank you, Ms. Kenedra.
Thank you for having me.
No problem. And I'll see you next time, same place.
Hello, I'm your host, Danaya Davis, and I'm here with Diamond Bell. And this is a new episode of Think Fast. So, Diamond, jeans or joggers?
Jeans.
Okay, why?
They're just more comfortable. Yeah, joggers it look nasty on some people.
Jordan or Nike?
Nike.
Okay, summer or winter?
Summer, no, yeah, summer.
Why?
Because I don't like being cold. Yeah. I don't like being hot neither, though. Summer, though.
House or condo?
House. Condos cost too much.
Car or truck?
Car. Car, yeah, car.
Nissan or Ford?
Nissan.
Infinity?
Who was that?
Affordable car.
Oh, I guess, I don't know.
Camaro or Mustang?
Camaro.
Why?
Because I was thinking that they're faster, but they're real fast. I don't know. The one of them look better. I think because the Camaro look better. Mustangs, they ain't got you.
Jacket or coat?
Jacket. Coat's too big.
Okay. Jordans or pants? Pants or boots?
Boots. Pants with boots?
If you on the right, who are you left?
Me, Diamond Zinger!
Short sleeve, long sleeve?
Short.
Nose ring, belly ring?
Nose, ooh, my belly ring. Nose ring. They look better. My nose ring be popping.
Would you rather have nose hairs or thick eyebrows?
Would they be coming at your nose? Like, I want thick eyebrows.
Braids or flat iron?
Braids. I don't like flat iron hair. It look weird. Yeah, it look weird. I got a big head. I don't like it.
Wax or threaded? Eyebrows.
Wax. Because I heard threaded hurt. Charity said it hurt.
It's all right. I mean.
You had it done before?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
It's like, it hurt at first, but. Okay, but anyway. Trees or flowers?
Flowers. They look pretty. Trees just bare.
Hardwood or carpet?
Carpet, because you can vacuum it. When you got a hardwood, you got to do a lot of sweeping and mopping with all of that. So, carpet.
Summer, winter.
Summer.
Phone or TV?
Phone. Because you can watch TV on your phone.
Empire Power.
Empire.
Okay, well, that's about it. This is, yeah.
Hello, I'm your host, Danae, and I'm here with Pearl Cohn football player, Bobby. Bobby, what position do you play?
Defensive tackle.
Do you start?
Nah.
What grade?
I ride the bench, but I'm a cold water boy, though.
You a cold water boy?
Yeah, I'm cold in the water.
I should talk to a real football player. Man, well, how do the game look?
How it look?
Do it look intense? Because yeah, you can't yeah, tell me it if do. It's intense if you're not on there.
It look intense.
What string is you? Like?
What string? Like 18th.
Then
well,
why
we got
you
a cold quarterback, though.
Who the quarterback?
Jimmy.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
Number one.
Yeah.
With the dreads. They died.
I just said I know who you're talking
about. Yeah.
I know who you're talking
okay.
about. Okay. Yeah. So, how you think y'all season going so far? I mean.
It's good. I mean, we started off bad. We lost versus Hillsborough in the NBA, but we've been doing better.
You right. But y'all got some good play. Who you think y'all top four players is?
Top
year.
Four. Mm-hmm. I had to say Jimmy, Toe, Lil High Wanjo every year.
Did you say that just because he here?
Yeah, I did. Sonny, I guess. I don't know.
Okay. All right. I don't know much about football, so I got a question because somebody bet me $5. Okay. Is a touchdown 7 or 6 points?
No, it's 10. You stupid.
For real?
Yeah, I'm dead serious. The touchdown is 10. Then
okay, you lying now.
Right.
I need to ask a legit person. So, you like y'all uniforms? Like, how many of them y'all got?
We got two new ones this year. We got the all black and we got the black jerseys and the white jerseys.
Don't you think it's a little unfair that y'all get to play for free and then the majorettes got to pay all that money?
No.
You don't think it's unfair?
I don't.
Not at all?
No.
I mean, you messed up. All right, that's real though. At least you was honest. So, when you do get off the bench, what do you do?
What do I do?
What are your position consist of?
My position? Just shedding blocks and getting to the ball, really.
What you do after you get to the ball?
Tackle.
So you don't ever touch it?
What?
You don't touch the ball. You just block for the person who do touch it.
Nah, blocking is... Blocking this offense when you on defense, the other team has the ball. So, yeah, you got to tackle them.
Oh, okay.
Okay.
pick a best player from each grade.
From each grade?
Mm-hmm.
Fresh. I don't really know any freshman players.
That's fine.
Bobby, freshman player. Bobby Bird. Yeah, because we got the same name. So. All right,
keep going.
Bobby. Sophomore. I guess Bam.
Junior.
On it, it's between.
Well, that's about it.
Yeah.
Goodbye.
Goodbye, y'all. Have a wonderful evening. Have a beautiful day. Sweet dreams.
You did it again.
How you doing, folks? Welcome to La Hada Honey's food show. And we got our guest here, JoJetta member. How you doing, JoJetta?
I'm good, thank you.
All right. Look, I've been meaning to ask you because you have your own cooking show. Like, what is your favorite meal to cook for your family?
Well, basically, I like cooking a lot of things. I cook different type of dishes, so I really don't have one basic thing, so because I just cook a lot of things.
Okay. I know you're not from America, so like in your country, like what's your favorite thing to eat over there?
Rice.
Rice. Okay. When you eat at home, like you just want to go for a snack, what's your favorite thing to eat?
I eat junk food.
Junk food?
Chips, all of that.
What kind of junk food and chips?
You know, hot fries, hot Cheetos, drinks, candies, all of that, honey buns, you feel me?
Okay, that's good. So when you eat your honey buns, do you put whipped cream on the honey buns? Because I hear whipped cream is very good on honey buns, you know, all type of different stuff. So I'm asking you to share with the people at home, is whipped cream good on honey buns?
Well, I've never tried it before, but I think it sounds good.
It sounds good?
Yeah.
Okay. So do you like Rotel dip and taco salad?
Uh-uh.
You don't like neither one of them?
Mm-mm.
Do you like hot wings?
Yes.
What kind of hot wings do you like, Georgetta?
I like all kind of hot wings.
Okay. What's your favorite kind? Like, if you had to choose and go to Buffalo Wild Wings or something, what would you choose out of all things? Which flavor would you choose?
I'm not really sure.
Not really sure?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So, when you look at me, what kind of food do you just imagine?
Okay, you look like a a turkey.
Okay. Well, look, this has been the last of the show, and this is Miss Georgetta Member. I'm Hyde, and thank you for watching La Hyde 100's food show. Thank you.
Welcome to the Hyde Talk Show. We're just gonna throw out topics and discuss our gossip. So how do you feel about Kanye West saying he's going for president in 2020?
That's dead. He don't need to be president of nothing.
Exactly. That's how I feel. Right, I mean, like yeah. What's he gonna? I'm scared. I'm really scared for him to be president.
I'm scared for whoever gonna be president. Because Donald Trump can't be president, Kanye West can't be president. That's dead.
It's not good for all of us. What they gonna, have you seen his clothing line?
Kanye West makes bad decisions. Look what he named his child, Northwest.
Like, what?
That's dead.
She don't know which way she wanna go. Like, I don't understand.
Kanye?
So, like, how do you feel about Future and Ciara not being together no more?
I think Future just doing a little too much. Like, I understand. Like, it's like he don't want her to go on with her life, but okay, y'all got a baby together. You didn't want her, you cheated on her. She doing her. What's the problem?
But she's stupid though. She should have knew that because he been cheating with whoever else he been with before. I mean, I'm a Future fan. I don't really listen to Ciara. Like, I don't like R&B. That's just not me.
I listen to both. Well, when I understand what Future's saying.
Right. Like, well, recently you've seen that Kevin Gates got married to Drika, which is his baby mother.
Kevin Gates look a little gay to me.
Yeah, he looks.
I like his music, but he looked
a little. He looks better with his beard. When he didn't have his beard, he looked like a straight stud.
Right, he looked like somebody studded auntie or something.
He's cool though. I really like him. He's my favorite rapper besides Lil Herb. Lil Herb, he needs to get out here. They need to put him in XXL magazine.
No, they need to put Tink on the radio.
Oh yeah, she cool. She coming out. She dropping. I got her Snapchat. She was fire. Huh? Her friend. It's called Gimme Tink. I'm going to give it to you.
All right.
Yeah.
Give it to me.
It's cool. Yeah. It's cool.
Chicago coming up. Nah, Nashville need to chill down.
Yes, because everybody's kids is dying. Like, but parents just need to get their kids. Like, why is y'all out here gangbanging? Like, I don't understand.
Exactly.
Just get your chat and we'll be going through this.
Right. What do the parents be?
Right. Like, your kids just running everywhere. Like, where are you?
Yeah.
And then they want to blame it on everybody else.
It's
not nobody's fault but your parenting skills.
Exactly. And then when a child is nowhere to be found, they don't know what to say.
That's it. My mama not having it.
Exactly. Mine's not neither.
Okay, but it's been real.
Mm-hmm, it's been a real good gossip.
On the highest talk show, and y'all don't know who he is.
Anonymous. So, yeah.
Guess that's about it. We'll talk to y'all later. Thanks
and
for watching.
For back home, we hope y'all come back and watch us again.
This your boy D-Lo, Bob King, and I'm about to get with something new for y'all. You know, everybody dance, they do their thing, but this that bet you can't do it like me challenge. Let's go like ooh, ooh, ah, ah, hey, hey, turn up. Ooh, ooh, ha, ha, hey, hey, turn up. Ooh, ooh, ah, ah, hey, hey, turn up. Ooh, ooh, ah,
nothing makes it got another hit.
Whip like me, can't really rock like me, can't sexy walk like me, can't hit the corn like me, hey, bitch can't drop like me, can't hit the folks like me, can't nay nay like me, can't Dino shuffle like me, like, no, bitch can't do it like me, bitch can't do it like me, no, 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 bitch can't do it like me, put your right leg up, left leg up, sit down like you sitting on the steps, look to the left, look to the right, look back, get a booty and stand up, twerk. I can't take myself when I step up on the scene, and all these haters jockey cause they know my swag be mean. I can do it by myself or I can do it with my team, but when I with my brothers,
oh, I think they like me. Clean pair of sneaks with a D's on her belt. Please watch your step cause I'm feeling myself. Throw a flag on the plate, man, somebody get the ref. God, blah, 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 blah. Man, somebody get some help. Pull up on the block. Hit the quad. Hit the quad. Hit the quad. Hit the quad. I said, get down low and swing your arm. I said, get down low and hit the quad.
I'm finna show you how to
hit the quad. Hit the quad. Hit the quad. Hit the quad. I said, get down low and swing your arm.
Say, y'all, baby, so good.
I said, get down low and hit the quad. Pull up on the block and do the dash like crazy.
We are students from Pearl Cohn High School.
We are a NECAT Learning TV production.
Some of our favorite parts were
technical director,
audio engineer,
set designer,
floor director,
and hosting.
Thank you, Ascend, for this opportunity.
We had so much fun.
Thank you!